And with one 2A game down, it is now time for the championship. We have Unity and Freeburg all set and warming up for the championship game of 2A. We just had the third place game finish with St. Edward claiming the third place trophy over Princeton. Again, we're going to have Jim Taylor and Kevin McCaffrey alongside to call the game again today here on RCN Broadcasting on hypercast.net. I will again remind you that the DVDs are available for order following this weekend for all games or any individual games that you would like to have. The championship games will be coming on later tonight. Will be 3 and 4A along with those consolation games. That will be in our second session following all the trophy presentations for first through fourth place in 2A. So when we come back, it will be Kevin and Jim calling the 2A Volleyball State Championship game here from Redbird Arena in Norman, Illinois, here on HCN Broadcasting.
Between Unity High School of Tolono and Freeburg High School. Of Unity, winner the match with the record of 27 wins and 12 losses. Please meet Coach Christy Duncan, who has a career record of 157 wins and 82 losses in her seven-year career. For the visiting team, the Midgets of Freeburg, winner the match with a record of 35 wins and 5 losses. Please meet Coach Lisa Bolt, who has a career record of 57 wins and 18 losses in her two-year career. And now, let's meet the players. From Unity High School, number 3, Meredy Robeck. From Freeburg, number 5, Kelsey Robertson. From Unity, number 6, Paige Bennett. From Freeburg, number 6, Brittany Hubert. From Unity, number 7, Jenny Martin. From Freeburg, number 7, Carly Volkamp. From Unity, number 11, Chelsea Davis. And from Freeburg, number 8, Amy Fournier. From Unity, number 13, Maddie Herbert. And from Freeburg, number 9, Sam Kassing. From Unity, number 21, Nicole Keenan. And from Freeburg, number 14, Annie Touche. From Unity, number 23, Jesse Spencer. And from Freeburg, number 30, Lucy Balch. And from Unity, number 25, Constance Evans. And now let's meet the starting lineups. From Unity High School, 5'2" sophomore, number 4, Emily Godsell. From Freeburg, 5'11" sophomore, number 10, Chelsea Hummert. From Unity, 5'5" senior, number 15, Lexi Gooch. From Freeburg, 6 foot junior, number 15, Colleen Yarber. From Unity, 5'9" senior, number 18, Anna Daters. From Freeburg, 6'2" junior, number 23, Kaylee Cox. From Unity, 5'7" junior, number 14, Danny Gooch. From Freeburg, 5'8" senior, captain, number 1, Kristen Wallig. from Unity, 5'7" senior captain, number 10, Bethany Billman. From Freeburg, 5'6" sophomore, number 12, Maddie Hogan. From Unity, 5'9" junior, number 9, Rachel Cunningham. And from Freeburg, 5'10" senior, number 13, Sarah Vollmer. And rounding out the starting lineups from Unity, the libero, 5'3" junior, number 20, Casey Woodworth. And from Freeburg, 5'5" senior, number 11, Andrea Bolt. The floor officials for this match are Mark Jackley and Becky Gillespie, who will serve as referees. Rich Kornfeind and Julie Terstrip will serve as your line judges. Barb Maui and Cindy Eggmeyer serve the IHSA as the officials' coordinators. Let's play some volleyball.
Conception, 2010, 6-20, 2011. And their coach, Lisa Bolt, second year, 57-18 for her. Christy Duncan, 7 years at the helm for Tolono Unity, 156-82. State title on the line in 2A. Just moments ago, we had our 2A third place game won by the Wave of Elgin St. Edward.
We get set. You can hear the fans. We're looking at the Tolono fans right across us, and they're maroon and white, many of them body painted appropriately today. And behind us and to our left, the Freeburg Lady Midget fans, as we get set to get it on and spike it down, looking for the championship in 2A. And the Rockets will begin with serve on our left side. Freeburg's going to be on our right side reserving here and receiving serve here in game one to start. Starting things off, it'll be Emily Godsell, their defensive specialist, a sophomore, to get the championship match rolling. Here we go.
Godsell with 22 ace serves on the year. Unity with 247 as a team.
To the center. Up back, quick attack. From the back, blocked out. Chelsea Hummer gets the first point in the championship match for the Lady Midgets, 1-0, and she'll go back on serve. Hummer, 5'11", sophomore. You know she'll be back next year. Her serve goes deep. Gooch tapped over. Cross court, blocked at the wall. Now Unity resets. Back runner, dug by the libero. Back bumper. Here comes Unity again. They reset. Now they go with a cross runner. And a dump over. Nice decision there by one of the Gooch girls. That was Lexi, who decided to go, instead of coming straight across, to go backwards almost with that little roller. And she got the point. We're tied at one.
It's going to be hard for them to hit through the block, and that's how they're going to have to approach it, with a running type of shot.
Kaylee Cox caught. Had a great swing, but she caught the net. And instead of getting the point, she loses the point. And it's the Rockets 2-1, although Kaylee Cox had a good swing at it off a nice set. Nobody was up there to block her. Now Lexi Gooch gets the ball. Starts deep. She'll make her approach for the jump serve. Pretty deep. Picked out by Bolt. Bolt back set. Cross court played. Dieters sets, played off the back there, and it was a good attempt there by Maddie Hogan to take the long ball in the backcourt, but she couldn't quite swing it straight, and it harmlessly fluttered to the side, down to the floor, and the Rockets are up 3-1 here in game one of the 2A championship. The Rockets of Tolono and the Midgets of Freeburg. And a net serve there. Didn't even come close to getting the net.
Well, it looked like, I tell you, that last shot that Unity scored on, that was played by Freeburg.
To me, it looked like that ball was headed out of bounds, but it was played by Freeburg.
Now Colleen Yarber, whose name we called quite a bit yesterday, the outside hitter. Little jump serve. Ace as nobody went. Everybody went for it, but they all went to the wrong spot. And Yarber gets an ace point, and we're tied at three. Yarber makes the approach, jump, float. The libero, Woodworth, and she sets for the dump point. And I think that was Danny Gooch on the dump there. In any case, it's 4-3 the Rockets. Anna Dieters on serve. Dieters, a 5'9 senior middle hitter. Jump serve, nicely played, nicely served. No return possible there by Chelsea Hummer. She had to dive to the floor and she buried it into the floor. And it's 5-3, Tolono. Again, a low serve there. Back bump off the setter. Now Tolono has to just play it over. Outside set. Long attack there. Kristen Wallig, she got it. She got a back set there from, I think that was Sam Cassing. And the setter put it away. A little bit of a reversal there. And that serve very long by Kaylee Cox. A little bit of pump up there. She just got the ball way too far. Rockets up 6-4.
Now she subs out, Cox does, and that neutralizes some of the size.
Right. And now it's much more even on the front row. And Danny Gooch, the setter, serving over. Dug by Harbor. Outside attack. Played long and no touch. All officials concur, no touch. And the point belongs to Tolono, 7-4. Freeburg just looking a little disheveled at the moment. Gooch to the right. Set, Kaylee Cox, the dump. Played off the net, still live. No, no, net violation. Looked like they called that on Rachel Cunningham on the net violation there. Probably her hands in the net after she tried to save it. Cox, not Cox. Wallig on the set. The net violation this time. Looks like it was Bethany Billman, excuse me. And Kristen Wallig continues on serve, now with the Midgets down 6-7. The dig, middle set, and a miss there as Rachel Cunningham tried the left hand, one hand, and she was out of position, couldn't get it across the net. Now we're tied, 7-up. Wallig, jump serve to the deep end. Woodworth, over the top there, one of the Gooch girls. Return, Tolono. Cross court set, Cunningham, softly played, return. Cross, Wallig.
Beautiful set.
Set a beautiful shot outside for Sam Cassie, who came around sort of a screen and got the ball down. 8-7 now, the Lady Midgets on top. Wallig continuing serve. Played by the libero, Woolworth. Blocked and blocked back in as Sarah Vollmer, right sider, 5'10 senior, got the block there. Didn't call Sarah Vollmer's name too often yesterday. Wallet continues on serve at 9-7. Gooch sets. Wallig returns the set. Four-timer there as Sam Cassing had a good look at it, but she couldn't quite clear the net. And the point belongs to the Rockets, 8-9. Bethany Billman on serve now for Tolono. Great serve to the short middle part of the court. Great dig there, but off the kill from Chelsea Hummer. She got a great cross-court set. Slammed it hard to the middle. There was an attempt made, a good dig attempt, but it was not a successful one. And the point goes over to the Midgets. It's 10-8. Here's Maddie Hogan with her sideways serve. Oh, that was probably out.
Misplayed. Breaks it.
And the serve played out. That deep floater was played sideways, just like her running serve. And it was played out of bounds, and the Midgets lead 11-8.
Well, I just kind of get the feeling here that Freeburg's taken control here of this match.
Gooch, cross court for her sister, and a net violation as Lexi Gooch caught the net there. Nice set by her sister, but she just caught the net on the downswing. And now it's 12-8, and the Midgets up four here in game one of the championship. And that serve just long. And Freeburg stops their own run there. They had a nice run going. 9-12 as the libero, Cassie Woodworth, serving for Tolono. Great serve there, a floater low. Great dig. That was Colleen Yarber with the power hit there. But on the double set, no point across. Pointed back belongs to the Midgets, 13-9. And now Kaylee Cox checks back in up front. And they go big again up front for Freeburg.
And again, we're seeing quick points on both sides. Not a lot of rallies here in this state championship two-way
Andrea
match.
Bolt, ace an ace serve there.
It touched the net, skimmed the net.
Skimmed the net, distracted it a little bit, but frankly, I'm not sure anybody was going to get there anyway. It was landed right on the backside of the eagle's beak, the redbird beak. It's not an eagle, it's a redbird. Gooch, Cunningham blocked. Rather, Dieter's blocked. And I think it was a net violation, but it needed space.
Yeah, I think it was on Cox.
Cox got too much of the, she got too much swing and got the net there. Gave the point to the Rockets, 10-14. Godsell returned up close. Wallach tries to save it back. And then on the carry, Wallach tried to bring it back there so that Cox could do something with it, but Cox was forced to pull it back from behind her head, and that's a carry. And it's now 11-14 as the Rockets try to climb back. They're down three. Godsell deep. Wallach up. Cox down. Wallach faked the short set. Cox came from behind, had a nice elevation, and it's 6 feet.
It's hard to believe late in this match that was her first kill for Cox.
At 6-2, she's got plenty of extension. She got the point.
Uh-oh, now the Gooch's tough angle, too.
Somebody's going to have to back bump it.
Nice play by Gooch to say that. But
tickling the twine, Wallach went to her knees to make a legal set, and she found Colleen Yarbrough, who came all the way from the backside, and we got ourselves a timeout here in game one. We'll be back in a moment. It's 16-11, the Midgets. Timeout. Tolono gets an outside hit, catches the line, gets the point, and an effective timeout there as they come back to 12-16. And it's Lexi Gooch on serve. Jumping, hitting corner deep. Wallach back set. Yarber blocked at the wall, but they're still alive. And Yarber trying to save it off the block, bumped it out of bounds. And now 2 points there for the Rockets as they close the 13-16.
Hogan was able to keep the play alive on the dig.
Nice jump serve. Plays it deep to Bolt. Back row attack there.
Ooh, Gooch with a nice save.
Crossed by Tolono.
Ooh, almost a lift.
And now Yarber on
the
runner.
The block.
She gets it through the double block there. Colleen Yarber, once again, a threat from any side. And especially when she gets a chance to run at the ball, she's got a big, powerful swing and good elevation. Gives the Midgets a 4-point lead at 17-13.
And they stop that push there by Tolono Unity, who was closing the gap.
Yarber's serve just along the end. Probably was out there, but you have to play it at that point. The block. Tolono restarts. And then a double set there. Danny Gooch tried to get a good set there, but her shoulders weren't square and she double set it. And the Midgets now have a 5-point lead and are seven away from game one here in the championship. Yarber, jump floater. Bumped out
by Unity.
Unity could not return the hard, it was really not a hard serve, it was a floater, but once again the floaters tend to knuckle around and that ball was knocked out of bounds. Here's Yarber, 6-point lead, looking to go seven. Great dig. Great serve there. The dig was made by Lexi Gooch, but she couldn't get it, the service ace. And now it's 20-13 and the Midgets can smell game one. From the back there, the block. Freeburg resets. Wallig on the outside, does not get the clear four timer. Point goes to the Rockets, slowing the Midget attack here for at least a moment. Freeburg's been here before, none of these current players have, but they've won two state titles. At the wall, Tolono tried to get a quick attack back, but Bethany Billman missed the ball. And she buried it in her own net, and it's 21-14 to Midgets.
Wallach did a good job, though, the setter to kind of get up there, jump up at the net, and impede the progress of the Unity player.
Cox serving. Gooch setting. Return now. Here comes Freeburg. Cross for Sam Cassing. Cassing got a long cross-court set, went over the top, found the hole in the middle in the backside, and she buried it away, and it's 22-14, and it's 3 points away, and a timeout. We'll take a break here. Redbird Arena, Midgets up 22-14, game one.
Hey, high school sports fans. Now you have your chance to keep the memory of your favorite IHSA championship event alive forever by purchasing a CD copy of this or many other IHSA championship broadcasts direct from the archives of the IHSA Internet Network. Events are stored on both single and double CD sets. Single CDs are priced at $14.99 and double disc events are priced at $19.99. Plus, each order does carry a $3 charge for shipping and handling. All of our broadcasts are stored on high-quality CDs, so you'll be able to relive again and again your favorite IHSA championship memories. To order, head to the IHSA Internet Network catalog at www.varsitygameoftheweek.com. Click on the Buy a Broadcast tab and search through our online store of archived high school broadcasts. Relive the memories forever from varsitygameoftheweek.com and the IHSA Internet Network.
We're back here at Redbird Arena. After the timeout, Tolono trying to find a way to solve the Freeburg power. And on the attack cross court, just slightly out there. And Tolono gets a chance to play again, 15-22. On serve, it's Danny Gooch. Serving long, too long. And a critical service error, giving the Midgets a 23-15 lead. And now Kristen Wallig hoping to be able to close it out. Setter return, dumped over, returned by Freer, played by Freeburg. Cassing, too far. Cassing had a good look. And in fact, she gets it off touch. Somebody up front, I suspect that was Rachel Cunningham. She looked to be the only person in the area. Got a touch, and now it's game point here in game one as the Midgets are up 24-15. Wallig. Serve return deep, jump ball, and just barely won there as Danny Gooch kind of got in the way there of Chelsea Hummert's swing as she got the ball just as it was going over and forced the error. 16-24, but now the Rockets have to block everything. Billman, jump serve, Wallig sets it, and down it goes. Game one on a Chelsea Hummert outside kill. And the final of game one, 25-16. Pretty much controlling the game after about the midpoint. And the Midgets take game one, 25-16. We'll be back in just a couple of moments. We're at Redbird Arena, 2A championship match. It's the Midgets up game one, winning game one, 25-16.
16 total attacks for Freeburg and only 17 total attacks for Tolono Unity. So, man, a lot of quick points.
Yeah, there wasn't, there were only a couple of rallies that went more than two across. Whereas in the consolation match, we had some 11s and 12s there. We were getting tired.
That third place match was exciting, even though it lasted only two games, won by Elgin St. Edward.
Freeburg starting with the serve here. Wallach setting at the net, dug out. Tolono pushes
it,
and the first point of game two, Danny Gooch, as she found an opening and pushed the point over to the corner. 1-0, Tolono.
And that's why I think it's to the advantage of Tolono Unity if they can get some of those long rallies and long volleys. I think that favors them. Boy, that kills you, though, when you...
And a service error by Lexi Gooch.
Talk about those quick points.
And ties the game at one.
Freeburg wants to put these points away in a hurry with their personnel they have on the floor.
Chelsea Humbert. Set across, deep set. Nice set there. Bethany Billman's got a great set from Danny Gooch. High, arced, and exactly where you need it, just inside the antenna. She had two places to look, down the line or to come back across the court. She chose the line and got it off the block. 2-1. Wallach, quick set for Cox, Doug. Tolono plays it back over. Doug, Cox has to backhand it. Yarber blocked at the wall, dug out. Yarber now with a swing, blocked. Gooch with a quick set. And she gives the quick set to Rachel Cunningham, and Cunningham puts it away, and it's 3-1 the Rockets.
And that's where I think, you know, you talk about those rallies favoring Tolono Unity. They're smaller but quicker, and more size and more thunder for Freeburg.
Cunningham, that ball was probably headed out. And then off block on the outside, Colleen Yarber. There's the advantage that Freeburg has. If they can get the ball outside to Yarber on a clean swing, she's got a chance to go over him, because they have to be respectful of Kaylee Cox in the middle there at 6-2. Here comes Yarber on the serve. Deep set. Gooch, quick attack. Nice quick attack. Sort of a back leader into the net there, and Rachel Cunningham got it off block. And it's 4-2 Rockets. Danny Gooch on serve. Rockets up 4-2. Looking to tie it here in game two. Deep serve. Yarber forced to backhand it. Wallach, quick set for Cox. Dumped but played. Pushed over by Tolono. Returned by Freeburg. At the net, block. Now Tolono has to free ball it over. And the libero, Casey Woodworth, knowing that she can't jump over the top of the net to hit it, has to take a swipe at it, and she doesn't clear it. The point belongs to Freeburg. Cox on the serve. Now they're going to have to free ball it here, Tolono. Wallig, cross court. Attack casting, Doug. Quick push over, dug out again by Freeburg. Back set by Wallig. Tolono, free ball and deep. No, they played it. That ball was headed out. Casting with a swing, gets it down. Well, Freeburg didn't do themselves any favors by playing the long ball there, but they got the point anyways. The ball came back into Sam Cassing's territory. And on the opposite side, on the outside rather, she smacked it down, and it's 4-4 tie. Nice return off there on the block. Cassing, Doug. Spencer in for Tolono. And the long attack there as Bethany Billman went just a tad long there, and the point belongs to the Midgets, 5-4, and Cox on serve. Gooch at the net, and that jump ball, not exactly a jump ball, but Jesse Spencer had enough of the ball and enough of Sarah Vollmer's attention that the point went to the Rockets. We're tied at 5. Great serve there by Bethany Billman. Now the block by Freeburg. Resetting. They have to back bump it. Gooch. And they're blocked. Woodworth. Return for Rachel Cunningham. And Cunningham got it on the dump over. I thought we were going to have a Gooch there. We didn't quite get it, as the Gooch sisters kept it in play, and finally Rachel Cunningham was able to dump it out. Rock 6-5. And net serve by Bethany Billman, and we're tied at 6. The Rockets can ill afford to give away serves. They have to get every point they can without having to rely on blocks or the bigger Freeburg front line. Gooch. Wallig now on the cross set. Cassing, Doug. Gooch, back dump, played. Cox, Cassing, that was a double apparently. Excuse me, that was Sarah Vollmer who tried to set Sam Cassing, and she doubled it. And it's 7-6 the Rockets. Now Casey Woodworth on serve, the libero for Tolono. And she serves net. Had a good swing at it, couldn't get it to crawl over. It hit the top of the net, just wouldn't crawl. One of everybody's favorite soft drinks, where it's 7-up. And the Lady Midgets on serve. Here comes Maddie Hogan with the sideways runner. Nice serve. Gooch rolled over, Doug. Vollmer, and again, excuse me, Maddie Hogan. Maddie Hogan double sets. Problem for Freeburg is they're trying to have 3 or 4 different people set, and they're not getting clean sets, and they're getting called for the doubles. And the Rockets pick up a .87 as neither team is able to establish much here in game 2. Wallig. Yarber down. Wallig gave Yarber the ball up high near the top of the antenna, and Yarber made sure that she put it away. No bow to doubt it. Tied at 8. Andrea Bolt, the libero, on serve. Bolt deep. Gooch plays it over and dumped back by Kaylee Cox. Gooch tried to catch him off guard there, but Cox had none of it. As soon as she saw Gooch go up, she went up. And Cox stuffed it back on the floor. 9-8 Lady Midgets, who own a one-game lead, looking for the championship here in 2A. Gooch. Return. Now the free ball coming from Wallig. Gooch. Dumped over. Played back. And a nice return there. Smart decision. That looked like Anna Dieters, who realized that on the free ball there, nobody was in the back row for Freeburg. Excuse me, for Tolono. Nobody was in the back row for Freeburg. And Anna Dieters took a swing at it, got the back line and the point. And we're tied at 9. Wallig. Back set for Cox. Thunder. Kaylee Cox bringing the thunder from the backside. 10-9.
Serving for Freeburg, number 10, Chelsea Hummert.
Number 10 serving at 10-9. And no clear there. Misplay off the floater serve there.
Point.
It looked like Dieters had a swing at it, but she couldn't make a clean swing, and she got stuck knocking the ball out of bounds. Now it's 11-9 Midgets. Gooch dumped over by Billman. Now Freeburg returns. Blocked. Doug. Wallach. Doug. Gooch. Billman. Doug. Got a long rally here. Wallach back bump. Gooch. Gooch back set. Dieters. And she gets it off the touch there. It was Lexi to Danny Gooch, and then Anna Dieters with the back runner. Off touch, got the point, and the Midgets. Rockets serving down 10-11. There you go, Kristen Wallach identified that nobody went up with her. It was a short front line, and she just jumped up and dumped it over. Got the point, and the Midgets are up 12-10. Colleen Yarber. Coming up for the jump serve. Net serve. And so the Midgets give away a point. It's 11-12. And now Danny Gooch will be serving. Danny, the junior setter. Sister Lexi, the senior outside hitter. Danny, deep center. Wallach sets back. Cox, Doug. Great return there by Wallach. Great dig off the floor. Casting Doug. Gooch. Now Freeburg on the return. Billman. Correction, Hummert. Hummert from the back row, played it just long. And Tolono picks up the point, and they tie the game at 12. Danny Gooch on serve again. Wallach, long set. Casting, thunder down. Everybody was behind Wallach except for Sam Casting, who waited on the outside, got the outside pass, hammered it down. 13-12. Back set, they're not going to clear it. Nope, the runner played too far for Bethany Billman to get at, and the ball played out. The point belongs to the Midgets, and they have a 14-12 lead, and Kaylee Cox on serve. Gooch. Cross court. No clear as Jesse Spencer tried to get it, couldn't get it over the top. And a timeout coming up as the Midgets find themselves up 15-12 in game two and leading game one here in the 2A championship. We'll be right back. Timeout. Freeburg, the lead, 15-12. Returning to serve, Sam Casting, dug out. Woodworth looking up front. Tolono dumps it over. Sam Wallach on a quick attack by the setter there. Dug out. Off touch. That was Bethany Billman dug out. Casting again. And she caught that there, I think, on the follow-through of her serve. Yeah, it looked like her.
Returning to the Unity lineup, number 11, Andrea Bull.
Had a little bit too much arm motion there.
That's the Freeburg lineup serving number 10, Bethany Billman.
With the serve, and it's Bethany Billman, senior outside hitter. Nice serve to the right. Wallach back set, Casting, off touch, and it falls to the floor.
It's a kill by number 9, Sam Casting.
Cunningham and looked like Cunningham.
Serving number 1.
Spencer got there for the block, but it fell harmlessly to the floor there, right on the nose of the Redbird. Gooch Back set. Played by Cunningham. Returned by Freeburg. Casting over. Gooch. Blocked and returned for the point.
Blocked by number 10,
Danny
Chelsea
said Lexi,
Hummer.
But Lexi was blocked in the middle. Nobody there to cover up as she came at a hard angle there. And the ball fell right on the eye of the Redbird. 17-13, the Midgets up with the lead. Dug out. Gooch, now Lexi Gooch gets it. Turns it over. Wallig casting the dump and the point. Lexi Gooch made a valiant effort at it after Sam Cassie
point.
Hit a roll.
Freeburg.
But it hit the floor, and that's all that matters. The point belongs to the Midgets. They're up 5-7 away from the 2A championship. Wallig, the serve. Great pancake to save that one. Billman pushes it over. Wallig, back set for Cassane, who hunters it down.
That's a kill by
that
number 9, Sam Cassane. Point Freeburg.
Wallig. She had the backhanded underhand.
Entering the Unity
lineup,
number 6,
Paige Bennett. And she got it over to Sam Cassane, who was looking for it.
Bennett.
And she just thundered it down from the outside, hitting the floor right in the center of the
Kristen
court.
Kristen Wallig still
and
serving for Freeburg.
And it's now a 6-point lead and 6 points away from the 2A championship for the Freeburg Lady Midgets. Gooch, back runner. Cunningham stuffed. Wallig, back set. Blocked at the net, crawls along. Somehow Tolono keeps it in play. Freeburg, Wallig on the quick set.
Kill by number 10, Chelsea Hummer.
Chelsea Hummer
point
got a
Freeburg.
Quick back set. And she gives them a 7-point lead, 20-13. And once again, timeout for Tolono as they find themselves down 7 points. We're here, 2A championship, Redbird Arena.
Number 15, Lexi Gooch, serving for Unity number 20.
They have the serve, but they're only 4 defensive points away from being eliminated from championship here. And the hammer, Chelsea Hummer got a free ball there, and she did not make a mistake. She thundered it down. It's 22-14, 8-point lead, and the Lady Midgets are 3 points away from their 3rd state title.
They scored the point so quick they haven't put it up on the board yet.
Oh, I take that back. There must have been a net violation. They gave the point to Tolono. So it's a 2-point swing. It's 15-21 and Woodworth on serve. But she returns the favor, unfortunately, for Tolono. Going deep and it's now 22-15. 7-point lead for the Midgets. 3 points away from their 3rd state championship. Here comes Maddie Hogan with the sideways runner serve. Deep right. Played over by the libero. Deep to the corner. Again returned by the libero, Freeburg. Wallig. Yarber blocked at the net or 4 times. It wouldn't have mattered. The ball fell back in the court anyway. The Rockets still trying to hang in there. They're down 6, 16-22. And it's Emily Godsell, sophomore defensive specialist, on serve. Everything's got to be in. Everything's got to be clean. Wallig, Yarber, down the line. Feeling fine, Colleen Yarber. 23-16, a little bit of a smile on her face. She knows they're 2 points away from the state championship.
6 kills for Yarbrough.
Andrea Bolt, libero serving, looking to close it out to her counterpart libero, Gooch. Dieters blocked. Wallig. Yarbrough thundered to the back. Colleen Yarbrough, a little bump there. And she knows they are 1 point away from the state championship. Here's Andrea Bolt. Will she put the point away here for the state championship? In fact, she does on an ace serve. It hit the floor. Bethany Billman got to it, but she couldn't get it up in the air. And you're 3-time state champions, first-time winners in a number of years. Congratulations to the Freeburg Lady Midgets. They finished the season 36-5, winning identical games 25-16. Congratulations to the Lady Midgets, and congratulations to the Rockets of Tolono Unity. They played a fantastic match here. They just did not have the firepower up front. Too much height, too much power. And the Lady Midgets in Freeburg take the 2A championship here in Redbird Arena. They'll be doing the awards in a little bit.
Well, and you look at, you know, the dominating performance turned in by Freeburg here. You remember in the first game, they got off to a slow start, some unforced errors. But they win 25-16, 25-16, just 49 total attacks for Freeburg today. 20 kills, 8 errors, hitting percentage 25%, 54 total attacks for Tolono Unity. But just 14 kills, though, and 9 errors. So 14 kills, 9 attack errors. And that's not a good equation there, and a hitting percentage of just 9%. And Danny Gooch was their kill leader with just 4. And 7 kills apiece for Yarbrough, and Cassing also with 7 kills for the Freeburg Midgets, who win the 2A.
Principal of Oak Lawn Richards High School, Dr. Doug Domaraki, principal of Gurney Warren High School. At this time, please meet the Tigresses of Princeton High School, who finished the season in 4th place. First, Superintendent Kirk Herring. Can you see? Okay. Principal Barb Schmidt. Athletic Director David Moore. Trainer, Dr. Richard Everett. Head coach, Andy Puck. Assistant coach, Eric Tinley. Assistant coach, Vanessa Madison. And now the players. Number 1, Sylvie Tracy. Number 5, Stephanie Bonucci. Number 3, Lacey Jensen. Number 7, Molly Stevens. Number 8, Tara Bonucci. Number 9, Caitlin Peterson. Number 10, Jolynn Kane. Number 11, Brooke Mueller. Number 12, Sarah Maynard. Number 13, Megan Gibson. Number 14, Jackie Kane. Number 16, Sarah Schlun. Number 18, Leah Shaw. Number 25, Jessica Martell. number 30, Jordan Mason. Manager, Justin Smith. And manager, Amber Rudder. At this time, please meet the Green Wave of St. Edward's High School in Elgin, who finished in third place. Assistant Principal, Rich Thomas. Assistant Athletic Director, Laura Jakitis. Athletic Director, PJ White. Trainer, Megan Sweeney. Head Coach, Jamie Walton. Assistant Coach, Kyle Dew. Assistant Coach, Matt Yan. And now the players. Number one, Molly Morrisrow. Number two, Margie Hagenjoes. Number three, Thomasina Domel. Number four, Holly Knott. Number five, Sarah Norman. Number six, Christy Knott. Number seven, Rachel Varley. Number eight, Kristen Hagenjoes. Number nine, Mary Kate Lamp. Number 10, Katie Yan. Number 11, Tess Berry. Number 12, Molly Kelly. Number 13, Christina Stojanovic. Number 14, Katie Aiello. Number 15, Christina Kolajajek. At this time, please meet the Rockets of Unity High School, who finished the season in second place. Superintendent Michael Schunk. Principal Phil Morrison. Athletic Director Scott Hamilton. Head Coach Christy Duncan. Assistant Coach Sarah Yinger. And now the players. Number three, Meredy Robeck. Number four, Emily Godsell. Number six, Paige Bennett. Number seven, Jenny Martin. Number nine, Rachel Cunningham. Number 10, Bethany Billman. Number 11, Chelsea Davis. Number 13, Maddie Herbert. number 14, Danny Gooch. Number 15, Lexi Gooch. Number 18, Anna Daters. Number 20, Casey Woodworth. Number 23, Jesse Spencer. Number 24, Corinne Fisher. Number 25, Constance Evans. And number 21, Nicole Keenan. Scorekeeper, Jeff Woodworth. At this time, please meet the midgets of Freeburg, who finished the season in first place. Principal, Greg Ferking.
Oh, that was assistant principal.
Assistant principal is Ben Howes. Athletic director, Steve Sergisketter. Trainer, Josh Nemo. Head coach, Lisa Bolt. Assistant coach, Jenny Hummert. Assistant coach, Julie Plazinski. And now let's meet the players. Number one, Kristen Wallig. Number five, Kelsey Robertson. Number six, Brittany Hubert. Number seven, Carly Valkamp. Number eight, Amy Forney. Number nine, Sam Cassing. Number 10, Chelsea Hummert. Number 11, Andrea Bolt. Number 12, Maddie Hogan. Number 13, Sarah Vollmer. Number 14, Annie Touche.
I don't know if you missed 11.
Number 15, Colleen Yarber. Number 23, Kaylee Cox.
Call her again, she wasn't paying attention.
Number 30, Lucy Balch. Number 11, Andrea Bolt.
MG.
Manager, Carrie MG. Assistant manager, Casey Wallig. Assistant manager, Jackie Yarber.
She just wasn't paying attention.
She was hugging everybody, yeah. Will coach Andy Puck and the members of the Princeton High School team please step forward to receive your fourth place trophy. And and will coach Jamie Walton and the members of the St. Edwards team please step forward to receive the third place trophy. Will coach Kristen Duncan and the members of the Unity High School team please step forward to receive your second place trophy. And will coach Lisa Bolt and the members of the Freeburg High School team please step forward to receive your championship trophy. Testing. Was that on?